Oh, a good-looking return set up here. Jamal Agnew. He will score. Touchdown.
We'll break down the touchdown later. It's two-point conversion time. Go to your script, pick your play, and go for it.
No time on the clock. Are we going to overtime, or does it end right here? A final shot now for Lawrence. And it is caught. They get it. So a touchdown and a two-point conversion with no time remaining. And we're off to overtime. I think we just witnessed the ultimate head-scratching moment. All they needed was the extra point to win the game, and they don't get the two-point try. Why did they go for the two-point conversion?
It is a head-scratcher, but I go back to when we sat down with them in our meeting, and they just kept coming back to special teams has just been not very good in practice this week. I wonder if that ghost loomed over them and decided not to kick it there and go for two, but still, I think your odds are a whole lot better just snapping and putting it down and kicking.
Yeah, I'm not buying it. You got to kick the extra point. The conditions only going to get worse as we get back to football here to start this overtime. And we will not see an attempt to match that return touchdown as this will be a touchback and bring it out to the 25. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go.
If you think back to halftime, you know, they were close to being written off. They faced the deficit, and now here as we begin overtime, they're one drive away from a comeback victory.
Think about where they started and how far they've come back from. And look, you and I both know that when we talk with coaches, most of the time they don't say that momentum is something that factors into how they coach a ball game, because they say each game is its own entity. But within a game, I think they all believe in momentum, and they certainly have it going in their direction right now.
On second down, here's a keeper by the QB.
Only a yard there on the keeper, and that's going to leave him with a third down.
Anytime you decide to use your quarterback as a runner, most of the time when you design a play, you're expected to break a little bit bigger than this one, because when you run him on short gains, the risk-reward and him taking hits, I'm not sure that's the payoff they were looking for.
That is caught. And now the races down the right side. Into the end zone for a touchdown and a game winner in OT. Well, you never know what you're going to expect when you come to the stadium to call a game. Sometimes you get good ones, sometimes you get bad ones, sometimes you get great ones, and that's what we had here. What an exciting finish on that last big play.
And I think that as we look at it, we're talking about a great finish, which went along with a game that obviously was dramatic because we did get into overtime. What type of play calls do you have left? What have you not shown? Or what have you made an adjustment to what you've worked on all the way through? It's going to give you the play we saw to win the game. But I know everyone's thinking that that was something that they just drew up. It might have been something they've been working on, and now they got the right matchup.
So for the Jaguars, they make amends for their week one loss by winning their home opener. And they'll get to stay home again next week.
This is the player card. Here are our players' motivations. How well your team aligns with each player's motivation.